Welcome to this introduction about DC, OS, and Mesos. The video is brought to you by Codecentric and Mesosphere. So, what is DC, OS, and Mesos? Apache Mesos is an open source project to abstract CPU, memory, storage, and other compute resources. It provides various API functions for resource management and to schedule workloads across your cloud. It is built to scale to 10,000s of nodes. Program against your data center like it's a single pool of resources. Apache Mesos is the heart of DCOS. Modern applications need a new kind of infrastructure. Microservices, containers, and big data components are built to scale. To support agile development, you need to build an environment that enables innovation and makes it easy to ship to production fast. The first wave of big data has just passed many enterprises. But with the second wave, we see a broad adoption of systems for strong personalization, Internet of Things, and a lot more. In the past years, most organizations treated their applications and servers like pets. They did everything to keep them healthy. For scalable systems, you better assume that your service will fail and be prepared to replace it with a new instance. DCOS is designed to run anywhere, on-premises and at your cloud provider. It abstracts the infrastructure below with Apache Mesos and provides powerful tools and best practices to build self-healing, distributed systems. On top of this, you can easily run your services and applications. Installing a complete SMAC stack can be done with just a couple of clicks. DCOS and Mesos are battle-proven in really large production clusters. Twitter runs thousands of nodes operated by relatively few admins. eBay uses Mesos for continuous integration. Microsoft uses it for the Azure cloud. Samsung has cut its infrastructure cost by 60%. Apple uses Mesos to run Siri, just to name a few examples. Some enterprises hesitate to adopt open source components due to the lack of support. The Infinity Stack contains state-of-the-art components for big data processing. The Velocity Stack provides a full continuous integration and deployment pipeline. Mesosphere offers premium enterprise support for DCOS and the complete Infinity and Velocity stacks. DCOS is open source. It is an excellent platform to run containers, microservices, and stateful big data applications. DCOS was developed by Mesosphere with the support of many well-known partners. It provides fast, push-button installation of complex distributed systems, ready to run in production. Frameworks are designed for built-in high availability and fault tolerance. No need to reinvent the wheel with every new application you build. DCOS will help you to simplify your data center. You can turn 1,000 machines into a single logical computer. With a simple GUI, automated placement of tasks, and intelligent workload scheduling, you can increase utilization and drastically reduce costs. Okay. Now it's time for a real-world demo. First, we will set up a 5-node cluster on Amazon Web Services. We will use DCOS to install Cassandra, Kafka, and a load balancer. Then we will deploy a scalable tweeter application and do some stream analytics on incoming tweets. Sound like a lot of hard work? It's not. Demo part. Step 1. For this demo, you will need an account for Amazon Web Services. We assume that you already created it. We will use the install instructions from dcos.io. Before we create any nodes, we will have to create a key pair. We give the key pair a name. Step 2. We will use the CloudFormation template from dcos.io to automatically create 5 cluster nodes. The cluster we create will produce AWS costs, so make sure that you shut it down after your test. The CloudFormation template is a simple JSON file that describes the infrastructure that should be created. Just follow the instructions to launch your basic cluster. Setting up the whole stack will take about 15 minutes. We are fast-forwarding it. Okay, now our servers and load balancers are set up. In the AWS console, we can get an overview by clicking on Services and EC2. we can see that 8 servers are running. From the server list, take the public DNS name to log into your DCOS dashboard. Step 3. Log into your DCOS dashboard. Clicking on Services, we can see that the Marathon framework is already running. Clicking on Nodes will show us a list of servers with their health status. By clicking on Universe, we will see a list of frameworks that can easily be installed on DCOS. First, we will install Cassandra and Kafka. With DCOS, this is just a one-click deployment. In the dashboard, we can see that the services are deployed in our cluster. Step 4. Next, we will install a Marathon integrated load balancer and deploy the demo Tweeter app via the command line. For this, we clone Tweeter from GitHub. Then we install the DCOS command line interface by clicking on the bottom left menu. Then we need to authenticate the CLI against DCOS. For this, copy and paste the URL into your browser and copy back the generated security token. Once the CLI is authenticated, we can try to run the DCOS client against our cluster. Next, we install Zeppelin, a tool for stream analytics. In Marathon, we can see that the service is deploying. Then, we deploy Tweeter via the command line. For this, we just upload the provided simple JSON file to DCOS. In Marathon, we can see that Tweeter is deploying. To be able to access Tweeter, we will need to deploy a load balancer that is accessible from a public network. Marathon LB is an integrated load balancer that will automatically route all requests to our Tweeter app. Now, all needed services are deployed and running. We access Tweeter via its public IP and port. In the last few minutes, we created a highly scalable Cassandra and Kafka cluster and deployed an application to it. Now, we will use the tweet tool to generate a stream of Shakespeare tweets. In Zeppelin, we import the Tweeter analytics JSON from the Tweeter app. With that, we can start stream analytics on incoming tweets right away. Rosalind seems to be the top tweeter. We can explore that with different visualization options. Next, let's assume an instance of Tweeter is dying. DCOS is monitoring the health of our applications and should start a new instance right away. a new application was started and taken into load balancing. More tweets are coming in. We need to scale. Scaling an application in Marathon is easy. Just increase the number of instances. It is also easy to scale down again. DCOS will automatically kill instances if too many resources are running. Okay, that's it for the demo. Don't forget to delete the tweeter stack in your AWS console to avoid further costs. That was a fast demo. Would you like to learn more about DCOS? Book your brown paper bag lunch today, and Codecentric will visit you without sales slides and marketing claims, but with technical details and sandwiches. Thanks for watching. This video was brought to you by Mesosphere and Codecentric. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe to our channel and follow us on Twitter.